morning, wonderful people of God. I want to bless your life today with the word of God. The Lord of the living, the Lord of Abraham, Jacob, Isaac. I want to share his word with you. Today, you'll be hearing the word of God from Evangelist Amankwa Richmond from Ghana, Ashanti region to be precise. God bless you. Shall we see a word of prayer? Wonderful God, we want to thank you for such a great opportunity. Lord, it is true that you are bringing all cultures, all people to yourself. We bless you for Jesus. We bless you for gift of life. It is true, as the Psalm said, it is the living who praise you. Lord, we come into agreement with you. We want to proclaim your word. Bring all people who are yours to your kingdom. Give you glory. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Amen. Beloved, today I want to share with you a message from the book of Ezekiel. Beloved, Ezekiel is a book that talked about the ancient Israel. And then let me bring it into our current domain or in our century, because it is believed in the Bible that we are New Jerusalem or we are New Israel because of Jesus Christ. Jesus came to bridge the gap. At the initial stage, it was only the Israelites, that is to say, those who came from the line of Abraham biologically, that had connection with God. But today, because of Jesus, because of the plans Lord God, Jehovah Jireh did, the Lord Provider, we can now boast of the fact that we are also sons of God. So this message today goes to everyone who want God to be his God, the God of the living, the I am that I am, the Lord who showed us love by giving us his son, that is Jesus Christ. So I'm reading from Ezekiel 3:19. Today we're looking at a message for the good and the bad. Then, before we talk about the message, let me try and elaborate small on what is good and bad. Let us come into our society. If you're talking about something good, that is what is accepted by all. And then if you're talking about something bad, that is deviant or things which are not accepted. So let's see what happened and then what the Lord told the prophet Ezekiel. When this message came to Ezekiel, the Israelites were in captivity. They were in slavery because of the sinful nature they lived. So if you're also talking about what is bad, it is what we do that is not good in the sight of the Lord. Worshipping idols, very, very important. Refusing to pursue the work of God, very simple. And then being good means joining with God in pursuit pursuit of his work. So let's hear the word of God, Ezekiel 3:19. If you do not warn an evil man and he doesn't stop sinning, he will die, still a sinner, but your life will be spared. Let me repeat it again. If you do warn an evil man and he doesn't stop sinning, he will die, still a sinner, but your life will be spared. Right. That means you and I, we have a task to conscientize everyone, to alert everyone, those who have joined with God in pursuit of his work, those who have surrendered to God and doing good, that vertical and the horizontal relationship is enlightened in his life. That is to say, loving God and loving humanity. The law centers on these two things. People who are pursuing this, they are also supposed to alert or create the awareness to people who are doing evil. That is to say, those who are not joining with God in love and humanity in love. People are in darkness. People even doing evil, doing things that will hurt brothers, friends. Nothing conscientize them. Nothing tells them to stop. These are people we are supposed to alert. And I believe with the grace of God, there is going to be change. Alright. So, we are supposed to tell the evil one to desist or leave their path to the path of eternity, to the path of God. Let's read chapter 20. If someone truly good starts doing evil and put him in a dangerous situation, he will die. If you do not warn him, he will die. So in our contemporary life, let's see ourselves as prophets. Let's see ourselves as prophet of salvation, prophet Ezekiel. Let's see ourselves in that manner. And then let's proclaim the word of God. Let us bring people to God. Even people who are doing good, they can go wayward, they can backslide. It is our work to encourage ourselves, help ourselves to maintain the good things we are doing for God. Nevertheless, if we don't do this, then a good person dies, a good person who go wayward by doing evil dies. His good deeds will not be remembered, and then somehow we are going to be responsible. So, children of God, brethren, this morning, what is very important, I have to tell you, if you are doing good, continue doing it, and I pray that the Holy Spirit will help you, to sustain you, to guide you and protect you, so that you continue doing your good, because sin is at its peak. People do sin to the extent that you can even touch the sin. It is deep and hurting. It is good to pursue what is right, live for God. Let's continue. I read. He said, if someone truly good start doing evil, and I put him in a dangerous situation. So if you are doing good, if you join hand with God in pursuit of his work, loving God, loving your neighbor, and then there comes a time you turn wayward, you are going to be in a dangerous situation. That is why the ancient Israelites, they went into captivity, they went to slavery. So if in our contemporary life, if you are doing good, if you are joining with God in pursuit of his work, and then you turn, you are going to be in a dangerous situation. So today, I want to encourage you. I want to beseech you that continue doing what is good. Continue the good work you have started. And then the Lord is going to bless you. Whereas you are able to do these good things, you are also to bring people closer to God. Encourage people, those who are pursuing good, even those who are pursuing bad. You pray for them, help them, so that they can join hand with God. It is this God that is loving. It is this God that can provide all your needs. It is this God that loves us, who wants to give us eternal life, who wants to crown us. So brethren, let's hold this man. Let's make sure we are joining hand with the people who are going to help us, encourage us, as Barnabas did for Paul. And then, in course of that, they were able to join hand to proclaim the gospel. That we even have their books that also encourage us after this time. And then, God told Ezekiel that I will not remember the good he did, and I will hold you responsible for his death. So if someone changed from his good way and become ignorant of it, or we see it as being nothing, we don't say anything about it, we don't go to them, we don't encourage them, the Bible is saying the Lord is going to ask us of the person's life, or the Lord is going to question us. So brethren, this morning, what I want to tell you is very simple. The good thing you have started, may God take you to a good end. And then I also want to make a positive appeal. I want to plead with you in the name of Jesus. And I pray that as I speak, the Holy Spirit will touch hearts. Now, any bad thing that we are doing, the Lord will draw us to his side, join with us in pursuit of his will. I believe God knows his people. And then it's time the Lord is going to bring his people, he's going to join hand with his people like never before, to expand his kingdom business. I love you. I want to end by saying that this work we have started is a good work. It's a work in the right direction. God is going to bless us. Our labor is not going to be in vain. Brethren, we are supposed to be our brother's keeper. That is what the Bible tells us. Whereas we try to encourage them, let's also address their needs, spiritual needs, natural needs, and then all needs. I believe if you do this, the Lord's mercy be upon our lives. God bless you. Shalom. Stay blessed. To meet the next time. Amen.